Today we're talking about one of the most revered sharks in the world, the bull shark, or Zambezi. Carcharhinus leucas, leucas meaning white, so that's the stomach shade is very, very white on a Zambi. Actually often gets confused for a great white when he rolls in the surf because he's got a very white stomach. Very, very big shark. Big, bulky shark, very, very large head, big stomach generally. General sharky type color, grey brown on the back. They occur more in your tropical, subtropical waters, although recently we have been catching them all the way down to places like the Breda River and further south. So places where people have been swimming their whole life in the river and now we're catching giant sharks in there. Which shows you they're not there to eat people. They're, as I said, the most revered, probably one of the most revered sharks in the world, second to the great white. They have the ability to tolerate almost fresh water, so they do travel far up big rivers, and that's where they actually get their name from, the Zambezi shark, is where they used to swim up the Zambezi River. And we're talking hundreds of k's that they're able to actually go up. As long as the water's deep enough, they can travel up there. They have very, very triangular shaped teeth. They can pretty much bite through a turtle if they wanted to. They are known for eating all sorts of things, similar to the tiger shark. They've often found rubbish inside of them and anything that's sort of floating. So a plea to not throw anything in the sea that you wouldn't eat yourself. For targeting them, the bigger the tackle, the better. If you want to specifically target a Zambi, a swim bait is pretty much your only way to do that. Now, when you say swim bait, we're meaning a very large fish of some sort, whether it's a grey shark or a garrick. Now, it's kind of a swear word saying to swim a garrick, but that or probably the most popular thing to swim for them would be a diamond shark up at Mtanzini and that whole north coast area. So it's done a lot more popularly up there because there are no shark nets, so you don't have to worry about stopping him within a certain distance. You're going to use extremely heavy tackle. Talking piano wire number 14 triple twisted with a 20-0 circle hook, something like that. You do catch them on bait every now and again. There have been guys that have caught them on whole chocker, on a whole slit bonnie and stuff like that, but that's really in the trance car. When you are targeting them on swim baits, you often catch a lot smaller shark than you think would attack your bait. So if you're swimming, say, a 40-kilo diamond, you sometimes get a 30-kilo Zambi coming out, and that's because they attack in packs. So you'll get 5 or 6 Zambies coming together in a pack and mauling the diamond, biting into lots of little pieces, and you just happen to hook one of the smaller ones. In terms of maturity, they're going to mature at about a meter, about 2 meters, 1.9, 2 meters thereabouts, and that's about a 20-year-old fish. They are very slow growing. It's one of those fish you've got to try and get back as quick as possible. We have mentioned how to handle the sharks. Keep your hands on the tail, keep away from the mouth. Keep your body very low. If it is a bigger shark, they're not designed to be out of water, so the gravity itself squashes them down, can damage their internal organs. So get a few guys to help. Don't have one guy just jerking on the tail, trying to pull it in. And keep as low to the ground as possible. The higher you go, the more stress you're putting on the back. They are a dangerous shark, so do be careful. They have killed people in the past. They have attacked swimmers. Not because they're specifically targeting them. There's no evidence to show that they specifically hunt humans. But they do. The shark's only way of actually testing what's good to eat and what's not is that it has to use its mouth. It can't feel you and ask you if you're okay to eat. So yeah, they do sometimes bite people, but it's not their fault. Now, the litters, they're born at about 75 to 80 centimeters, and they have fairly big litters, which is one of the saving graces for them. They're about 10 pups in a litter, also giving live birth. And that's a gestation period, so they're pregnant for about 10 to 11 months, so very similar to people. In terms of similar species to them, there's only really one that you can confuse with a Zambi, and that's a Java shark, otherwise known as a pig eye shark. Now, pig eye, because it's got a very small eye compared to the rest of the body, and it looks like the eye of a pig when you've taken it out. We will do a video on the comparisons between the two, but basically the Java's just got a much higher dorsal fin and it's a bit slimy. When it comes to actually doing the measurements of the Zambezi, so doing your weight conversion, because we don't weigh them in slings anymore, you're going to measure to the pre-caudal notch. So a giant sand shark, you measure total length, so that's all the way to the tip of the tail, and then most other sharks you're measuring a pre-caudal length. Now the shark's tail, if that's the tail itself and that's the body of the shark, it'll have a little notch just before the tail. It's called the pre-caudal notch. Caudal means tail, so that notch there just before the tail, you measure from the point of the nose all the way to that notch. That's what's called a PCL, pre-caudal length. So if you see that on species recommended, that's the length that you have to measure to. When it comes to tackle for Zambezi, as we mentioned earlier, the heavier the better. You're looking at, if it was me setting up a tackle specifically to swim and bait for a Zambezi, because you don't know what you're going to pick up all the time, I'd say the new Dogfight Multiplier. That is the newer version of the old Saltiga LD60. That's loaded with as much braid as you can fit on there, putting a very heavy wind-on leader onto that, and then contrary to popular belief, you want to put that on a slightly softer rod. So I wouldn't go more than the 6 to 9 ounce, because the fight is going to be quite a long one. If you're using the 8 to 12 or something similar, it's a very stiff rod. To actually be able to put enough pressure on that the whole fight is going to absolutely murder your back. So use something with a bit more tip action. 6 to 9 can pull amazingly strong fish. So I'd recommend that. Use that on a rod. You can lean into it. You can actually put a bit of hurt on the fish and get him out quicker, so that you can get him back as quickly as possible. And yeah, the heavier the steel, the more chance you're going to have. I've seen them bite through 250 pounds, so don't be surprised if you do get bitten off. And yeah, one of those species that's definitely on a lot of people's lists. So go out, swim and bait, and test out your tackle. Cheers.